So we know that the brains of synesthetes are different in the sense that they have greater white matter organization in various regions and also greater cortical thickness. But another suggestion is that the changes in the brain might determine what gets paired with what in synesthesia. So one suggestion that's been put forward by Ramachandran and Hubbard is that graphemes and colors get paired together because the grapheme recognition area of the fusiform cortex is adjacent to the color area of the cortex. Now, this is a nice suggestion about that type of synesthesia, but the test of it is how it applies elsewhere. So one of the things that we've looked at is a group of people who have synesthetic tastes. And what we're interested in is why do certain words have certain tastes? Now, we know in the color domain that why certain words have certain colors, and it tends to be to do with their spelling. So the word table might have the color of the letter T, for example. The word theater might also have the color of the letter T. So if T is blue, theater might be blue and table might be blue. But this is interesting because the sound is actually different to a th and a t. These are actually different phonemes, but they have the same color. In the taste domain, it seems to work very differently. So words that that have the same letter at the beginning don't tend to have the same taste. What happens in the taste domain is that it's to do with the sound patterns. So for example, words that rhyme tend to have the same taste. So maybe table, cable, and sable all taste of oranges, for example, because they all rhyme together, even though they have a different starting letter. And this seems to be true over pretty much all the cases that we've found. And there is really no cognitive explanation for this. It's hard to imagine a cognitive theory or behavioural theory as to why the tastes of words is dictated by the sound pattern and why the colour of words is dictated by the spelling. So we think that the answer to that probably is to do with the neuroanatomy of how taste and colour is and where it is located in the brain. So taste is more or closer to spoken language in, for example, Broca's area being adjacent to the insula and also the auditory cortex, which is nearby to the insula. Whereas in the fusiform, this is a more visual area that is involved in graphemes and colours, and this is why it goes together. There are possible exceptions to this adjacency principle, though. So coloured music, for example, would be one example of this. But there are buyouts for it. So, for example, the fact that in the normal brain there are strong connections, at least early in infancy, between auditory regions and visual regions could be an alternative explanation of that. So it could be really what tends to get connected together in the normal brain determines what type of synesthesia, you know, you're going to have. And you know, even in the normal brain, we tend to connect with things that are nearby. That tends to be a general rule of the wiring of the brain. So adjacency is part of the story, but it's certainly not the whole story.